never really liked apples, though heaven knows I tried. 'Cause it's just weird to hate apples, so for years and years I lied. I never really liked apples, it's not a choice per se. I don't know why, I guess that I was simply born this way. In Spokane, where all they've done is grow apples since the day the world began. So I hid my feelings for apples, it's a skill I learned to hone. And as I grew, I guess I knew I'd always be alone. But I've always loved oranges from my earliest memories, even though there's no orange trees in Washington State. Yes, I've always loved oranges. It's an urge I was shy to admit. To me, apples were apples, but oranges were it. Well, I left home and the apples, passions to pursue. I started my own adventure and enrolled at NYU. I was shy and minded my business, and I met Mike one day. He seemed so nice, so I broke the ice and found the nerve to say, I've always loved oranges. Crap, what a strange conversation start. He said,
dude, here's the strangest part. I like oranges too.
We're two guys who like oranges, who were sent a clear message by fate. You don't have to like apples. Oranges are great. That moment left quite an impression. That moment, a light bulb went off. I remembered the years of repression and my worries that people would scoff. All those times that I tried liking apples seemed at once like a meaningless waste. And I learned there with Mike that you like what you like, and there's just no accounting for taste. Now we're proud to like oranges, and we walk with our heads held high.
Because I found another guy who loves the things that I love.
And so did I. We both love oranges. He's so handsome and
he's awfully. There are those who like apples and those who do not.
So whatever your preference, embrace what you've got. It's a big world.